Okay, I'll call this special council meeting to order for November the 2nd. Can I have an approval of the agenda?
So moved.
Any discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor? Opposed? It's carried. One item under new business, a report from the engineer on the extension of the transit bench agreement. Ian.
Mr. Chair, this was an oversight on staff's part dating back to September 2015. We run the risk of losing all the bus benches effective November 7th. So staff are recommending that we do an extension for 1 year and then follow through with our original direction to follow up with a report.
Thank you. Open it up to council. Jason.
Yeah, I agree with the first part. The second part of the recommendation, I'm just curious why they're recommending a 15-year term to the agreement.
Mm. Ian?
Mr. Chair, I'm not sure why they're recommending 15 years. I suspect that's probably consistent with what we had done with Pattison signs. I think that was the only reason they were doing that. But council can direct us to do whatever they would prefer.
When here it says that at the September 28th, 2015 meeting that the council actually passed a resolution to enter into the agreement with Pattison, that was never followed up on? It was approved, but we never approached them or never followed through on it?
Well, Mr. Chair, there's two issues here. One is the benches. The other is the shelters. So we issued a 15-year contract with Pattison for the shelters, and then we terminated the contract with COA for the benches, or we were directed to terminate. We didn't terminate.
Cynthia?
Thanks. There's a couple of issues for me. We have now three different types of infrastructure in Colwood then to do with transit. We have bus shelters that are paid for and maintained by us. We have bus shelters that are paid for and maintained by Pattison through our contract. And then we have benches at our transit stops that are through the COA contract that we're talking about. So I think it's really important that we get the lines of communication straight, because it's my understanding that our staff, our public works staff, were not aware that they needed to do the maintenance on the bus shelters that are not Pattison bus shelters. So they need to be cleaned and maintained by us. And that came forward through the Disabilities Committee, because they brought forward one that was kind of unkempt, and so it has been rectified. The creative outdoor advertising benches, I think, could be a better design, and I understand that's something that was identified when we brought it forward before, and then gave the notice to terminate, was that the water pools on those benches, so they're really wet to sit on if it's been raining. Even if the sun comes out, they're not drying very quickly because they hold the water. So I think we're looking, I don't know if it's so much important who the contract is with, but what we get out of the contract is more important. So consistency, and this was a way for us to do it at relatively low cost through having the advertising on the benches, but we haven't considered recently any idea for having our own type of benches that would not require any advertising on them, because we did bring this forward in a time when Colwood could in no way afford to do benches. So just something that we may want to consider. Do we want advertising on the benches so that we save that cost? And whether or not there is a maintenance plan, and whether or not the Creative Outdoor might be able to offer, or anyone else might be able to offer us a style of bench that would be better in all weather conditions.
Thank you. Ian?
Mr. Chair, several of the staff would like to have a conversation about putting in benches that don't have advertising, but it would certainly fall into a budget discussion because it's an increase in service levels that we'd want to have approval from council to proceed, and we'd want to be able to tell you how much that would cost, because right now this is not only cost neutral, it's a revenue source for us right now. So there'd be the lost revenue and the additional costs of buying the benches, maintaining and replacing them. So it is a departure, but there certainly is a feeling among staff that they would like to consider that. So we would have to bring that forward as a budget consideration for council. And I think there is an intention that we would do that. But on the immediate need, that's going to take us through till May. And if we didn't renew this 1 year, we wouldn't have that opportunity to have that discussion.
Silha?
Thank you, through the chair. There's also the note that there's 22 benches, and they can make up to 25. And I realize there is a constraints dealt with in the past, but last time we renewed it was in 2011. So I would just hope that if we do go forward with renewing, that we would take another look at that.
And I would just add my two cents worth. I wasn't actually in favor of the current bench program. I always thought that we were selling our souls by including advertising. And for me, I think the street furniture really has an impact on the aesthetics of a neighborhood. So you put in a crappy bench like our, and this is my opinion, what is out there now, it can really bring down a neighborhood if it's not attractive and functional. And I think Cynthia made a good point. Many times it's not functional if there's inclement weather. And they're on pads, so they're not necessarily stable either. They're not in concrete or anything like that. So I've seen that kids move them and all that sort of thing. So I guess in the interim, I'm okay with it being extended just so we don't rip them all out. But certainly if staff is interested in having that conversation to determine kind of what direction we want to move into, then I wonder about option number two, then kind of backing off on that one, Ian, until we figure out what that direction is, because we don't want to put out a...
Yeah, Mr. Chair, council is leading towards a preference for city-owned, non-advertised benches, then direct us to bring this forward to budget, and we'll make sure we have a package ready for council. Okay. It doesn't preclude still going out to tender, it just postpones it a bit longer. But this is certainly on our radar this time, so it'll be dealt with.
Who is Jason?
I'm really in favor of us investigating our own benches without advertising, and I would like to see that come to budget. Should we decide not to, then we can put this out to tender. I don't think they need more than 6 months to register a tender, so I'd be happy to move recommendation one and make number two that staff be directed to bring a report to budget regarding Colwood replacing the current benches with Colwood's own benches.
Okay, we have a mover. Do we have a seconder? Seconder and discussion on the motion? Cynthia?
Just that... So we're not doing anything with the second part. Never mind. I was stuck on something. I'm good now.
You're good now? Okay, any further discussion? Council's clear on the second bullet point? Okay. All those in favor? Opposed? It's carried. That was it. And I cannot move adjournment.
I'll move adjournment.
All those in favor? Opposed? Carried.